Students of underground coal mining methods MN2102. On this 21st class lecture on 2nd February 2021. If my voice is clear, I will start sharing the slides and we will start our online interaction teaching learning process. After a wonderful speech yesterday by our beloved Director General of Mines Safety, your super senior Mr. Prabhat Kumar, who was with us and with you also online, I thought you must have got that opportunity to interact with him. Of course, he will be available all the time for our beloved students to learn more that already during yesterday's interaction, you must have understood. Now let me know if my voice is clear and I am audible. Then if there is something like this, or like this, after we can, you can make a call to me anytime so that we can continue our class without any problem. Now I'm sharing the slides, and before that, let me know how many of you could join online yesterday during the interaction with our beloved Director General of Mine Safety, Mr. Prabhat Kumar, who is our 1986 batch from NIT Rourkela. Anybody can unmute and tell me they could join and had the opportunity to interact with him. If there is any connectivity problem, okay, no problem for us. Now, welcome back, my beloved students of underground coal mining methods, MN2102, on this lecture 21 for our online teaching learning process on 2nd February 21. We are discussing about different aspects as we did it up to the last class, of course, telling about, reiterating about our interaction and understanding the present problems of underground coal mining, and when they go beyond 1 kilometer depth, what we are supposed to do. All these things we could discuss yesterday in details, and DGMS is ready to cooperate with all the institutions, including all my beloved students who are coming forward to learn more and become a part of our Atmanirbhar Bharat and Make India. And that's what we have given yesterday. Who missed it, they can see this is what was ours on our behalf, and another is here for you to show. I just kept it like that. Okay, now continuing further, when we design any support systems or the mining methods, we are supposed to understand its behavior also, behavior of that mining method as a part of that mining method, whether that method is working well or not, whether it suits other conditions or in these conditions, what other precautions we have to take. So we do lot of instrumentation, but these issues I am showing as a part of whatever is a case study, but in details we will go based on your interest and in further classes. As a part of it, it can be stress capsules or some other instrumentation, like this is that panel what I was showing you as a part of our investigations in one of the mines where there is a sill, very difficult to cave roof in the overlying strata with around 120, 130 meters of thickness below that sill. And people thought that can be a sufficient as far as the capability studies are concerned, and then we can go ahead. And all those details we discussed, I showed you all the sections also, which you understood nicely. Now, these are different, and now you see when there is a split here, and then this is the slices, and then snooks and drips, all those things you understood. Then these are different type of load cells or stress cells. And of course, these are different instruments like rotary tails. And these are some names I wish that I should bring to you as a part of that any mining method implementation or like that. But other details, definitely we will be going in detail depending on your interest. And this is the way how it appears to understand what is the behavior of the strata when we implement any mining methods, and especially where we are implementing some experimental trials, new mining methods. These are all the details required. That's why just I tried to show you. And these lines, this is a line of extraction, and the, when that falls took place, major fall or local falls, this is where how it appears. And these are some names of that, whether it is a telltale instrument, and then this is the way how it appears as a auto warning telltale instruments that shows whether there is a movement after your predefined setting. If it is 10 millimeter, 20 millimeter, 30 millimeter, depending on your setting, if it exceeds that much of deformation, then it will give some indication. That is why we are calling it as auto warning telltale. Otherwise, it can be something like a vernier caliper or rotary telltale, when the movement, any distance or displacement will be in terms of this. This is what, when you visit any mines, you may be seeing this. That's why I wanted to show to you, my beloved students, when you visit any mine, this type of instruments you will be seeing. This is called a rotary telltale. It can be anywhere. Now it can be in the deep drilling panel, it can be in the long wall panels. And this is what I wanted to show you. It is in the roof. Now you see, when it is a up to 5 millimeters, we kept it, or this is the way how it is manufactured also, that can be changed depending on our requirements. Then this indicates that there is about 3 millimeter at that time when we have taken a photograph of displacement which took place. This is around 2. Then up to 5 millimeters of displacement, if it is a roof, then you can think it is coming down by 5 millimeter, right? Then we consider that as a green color. It is something like your traffic signals, right? When you are allowed to go without any problem, so it is safe and stable, you can work. And then when it is after 5 millimeter, it is marked as 5 to 10 millimeters, then it is in the yellow color. Yellow color implies to be little, just like our whatever traffic light, so then be more cautious. Beyond meter, when that coming down, assume they support. Okay, so your, and this is a roof. Your person is working. Meter, there is some. This 10 can be 20, 30, depending on your way, how you want to design, how you have done your previous investigations and shared in different panels, whether it is a long panel or a wooden pillar panel, because today itself we would like to finish a little bit of mass exploitation around two wooden pillar cutters. Later we will discuss even about the stoning issues of stoning. It's my which is very important. That's what we plan on this 21st class, because by 20 classes we should almost finish to 50% syllabus. You should finish your mid-sem evaluation also. And I am sure you have done an excellent assignment in your national format, and you may be some of you may be ready. You have to present to our other people, right? You are part of second part assignment and you are presenting about 10 minutes. So this is the way how you plan, and depending on your topic of interest, something like that. Then later in the red, when it is moving, so they're supposed to be more cautious. This is the way how it was designed, and then it is the way how this instrument is also designed. This is called a rotary telltale, and other one is called auto-warning telltale. And then there will be different parts of how it is installed and put in the tank, and how is you many times that strata whatever is there. This may be you may even hear. I'm showing it the who is able to hear, but when you have a lot of experience, you can hear the sound. Your mind sarga, who is there, a person like this, so he can, okay, the sound, he can say whether that sound is coming from the roof or sandstone is breaking, or from the sides where it is breaking also. That much of experience people will be having it, hearing the sound. Except they can say that is where experienced people, although they cannot see where from that sound is coming, right? So that means into 2 meter inside the roof or 5 meter inside the other things, but they hear and say that it is the caution or some warning that some coal is breaking or some stone is breaking. So these type of things are there. But when it is breaking, some bending or many times even without bending also it can break. So all those things are engineered. So instrument, some type of instrument, and then to quantify collectively, we know that this is happening quantitatively. As an engineer, and collect data, and that will be useful. Your other non-coal mining methods and in the similar condition, what will happen, what may happen, right? That you will be able to predict, or you can give some proper warning. This is the reason why all things, instruments and other things are done. For this, in 2017-18-19, like that, it was done. So I'm not going much details at this stage, but since I am showing how that case study mine is a typical mine, then is a stress. You can see how much stress was there on 13 January, when it is 31 January, is a day when more stress was there, maybe 300 kPa² and other things. So that's where, in that, when this mass exploitation by continuous miners were in that conditions we discussed, the current is from to flow. So he's using up to 20.
Sir, you are muted. Please unmute yourself. Sir, please unmute yourself. Yes, sir, you are audible.
Clear?
Yes, sir.
Very nice. So now let me also show it to you. Yes, right. Let me take your attendance also once here itself. This becomes easy for us later. Then you are able to see the slide now.
Yes.
To see, Very good. So when we adopt any type of this underground mining, coal mining methods, as I told you, and another time also you may note down, because there are some methods which were indigenously developed, and when they were experimented, then that type of methods are supposed to be monitored in detail. That's where we call it as a scientific experimentation of underground coal mining methods. Were done, a lot of methods were experimented in CMRS, especially by Dr. T.N. Singh Saab and the team long back. And that's why these are what we experimented in NIT Rourkela and showing to you people now. Right. Then this may be in panel A, this happened like this. In panel B, so there it was within 20 millimeter. And in other places in panel B, it was about 28 millimeter. So this gives some idea that when you implemented this type of method, then there is a possibility that in the similar conditions when you experiment or when you are implementing these mining methods, then this may be the behavior. So to take care of that, this may be the support system required. And to take care of that, you have to reduce the rib width or width of the galleries or pillar sizes. All those things you will be monitoring it. I mean, you will understand in this. So all these are a part of implementing any mining methods. We should understand that the reason why I try to bring to you, maybe our students of underground coal mining methods. Then there is another important issue which you should note down. Here you see there are artificial lines of fracture was induced by blasting around the gopher edges. So mainly what happens whenever there is a roof, that roof is now acting like a continuous beam or a plate, and that may take little more time to fall or to cause any type of roof fall or a gulf fall or caving or a gulf settlement. So that's why some induced blasting is required, especially in our caving mining methods, where there is a roof which is not very weak, or the roof which may be sometimes very strong. Of course, if it is very difficult to cave, in fact, we are not supposed to even go for the caving methods of mining. That issue already my beloved students understood. But in general, it brings down your gulf settlement, or the time required or the span required may become less. And whenever there is a gulf fall, then your stress is relieved. That is a stress. After that gulf fall, whatever stress is acting into the advanced working or abatement loading trend, what we call about it, that will be less. Otherwise, up to the major fall, what happens, then your gulf, it is not filled with your material, then all that load is being transferred, and all the time your pillars in advance or hips adjoining your gulf edges will be always under high pressure or high stresses, which is very dangerous. And that also causes sometimes overriding of the pillars. It is not overriding of the pillars. And that is for today. You see the question, what in the previous classes you must have understood about this. That's why I'm writing it as a CEP1. What is this overriding? Overriding. Since we are talking about the overriding of pillars, because in previous semesters also, you must have definitely got this terminology while reading about this. What is this overriding of pillars in declaring, especially? So this question, CP1 for you. Then meanwhile, we continue with our class. you think about it and then before summarizing, definitely you will like it. So there is induced blasting around the roof edges, that and that causes some type of the fixed beam, whatever is there, that will become like a cantilever when one side of it is blasted down. So that's what is that. That's the induced blasting. That all the details also we'll be discussing. And depending on, again, I told you, your interest, and many students must have got all the information, and they will be discussing while presenting their assignments. And at that time also, I will be giving you a lot of information, what is happening related to those any typical issues as far as underground coal mining methods in India or elsewhere are concerned. Now, these natural faults, many times what happens before any induced blasting is done, so there is a very less chance, unless it is very weak. If it is very weak, it is very simple to understand that it falls on its own when some span is exposed. Very simple to understand. And then sometimes what happens after inducing the fall, since that is becoming a beam, whatever, this also you must have understood. So when there are layers, this is only your attendance list only, when there are layers like these, right, like this, these are the layers, different layers, I hope. Are you able to see these things? My beloved, I am showing you also here. Are you able to see? Yes, no problem. You may have some connectivity problem, some people. Yeah, very good. So now you are able to see. Okay. So this I am replacing by this. You are also able to hear, right? So when this is the layers, if these layers are there continuously like this, go, consider, you think this is a section, and then extracted inside the go about 10 meter, 20 meter, 30 meter, one more pillars are go, and you have advanced workings here, and this site is go. So advanced working where persons are here, and that site is go. So these layers are bridging, and then it is something like a fixed beam from the barrier to your working place here. When you make a blast of up to 1 meter, 2 meter, 3 meter, that induced, that's what is the meaning of this red color, what I kept as artificial lines of fracture. We are creating up to 1 meter, 2 meter, 3 meter. When I blast this, what will happen? This layer, whatever are the layers there in the gulf, when I blast this, that means this layer up to this, I have blasted up to certain distance. Then this layer is blasted down. So some part of the gulf is filled with that material so that there is less chance of your air blast also when some material is already filled in the gulf. And this is leading to the next layers got exposed, and that layer also starts falling. And that becomes something like this natural fall, whatever I'm talking about. So this, there is more chance of natural falls occurring when there is a artificial lines of fracture created with induced blasting. So that's what is a practice. It is invariably done in almost all the conditions in Indian coal measure strata. So this may be required in some other mines like Germany or Australia or US. Some mines where the roof is not so hard. So when it is 10 meter, 20 meter on its own, it may fall. So at that instance, it may not be required. So those lot of investigations were done, especially by us also in Ministry of Mines or our CMRS, whatever, right? So I will be giving you a lot of data on that, and many papers also you can see, so many things, right? Depending on the interest, you can learn more and more. Now, but that natural falls were extending even up to 3-4 kilometers, not kilometers, meters, and then into the roof, So it is very simple to understand when that fall is taking place for 3 to 4 meters. So that material is bulking, right? So that fills some part of the gulf, and that gives less chances for air blast and other things, right? So when there are more strong layers, right, followed by your settled gulf, the existing practice of induced blasting with far existing output, then whatever induced blasting is done, this is done up to about 3 meters inside the roof. That's what I was trying to tell you. Sometimes in some places we do up to 2 meters into the roof, depending on the roof condition. So what ultimate purpose, I hope you understood why we are doing this induced blasting caving panels. Because in storing panels, it is not at all required, because our purpose is to backfill, and then the roof should not get disturbed. That's what is the practice. The storing will go little further in the subsequent slides. Now, even special observation, as I told you, so this increased even the distance from gulf is about 10 meters and fall occurred without any indication. There are so many instances what happens as far as the observations are concerned. This also gives some idea for us. Sometimes some warning also we can get it, but it is again site specific. So let us not go much into that in details, but let us go much into the mining method and what happens in that. And similarly, whether it is in the panel, and even also you can understand here that there may be sometimes when while doing any type of experiments, there may be some chances of behavior which is beyond your expectations. Sometimes heavy bumping sounds occur, especially on this day. Everything I'm showing done from the extract of this type of reports from the investigations what from NIT Rourkela we have done. And Mr. Prabhat was asking what are the mines where we are doing investigations and where we can contribute from our NIT Rourkela, and especially DGMS is also recognized long back, decades back. Those who must have seen yesterday online, they must have seen at the end when there were no many questions, I just tried on your behalf to ask our beloved DGMS, Mr. Prabhat Kumar, what steps they are taking as far as the more scientific and innovative mining methods as a part of DGMS recognized as an excellent institution. Then his response was also so good. Now, so many of our beloved students also can go and even visit the DGMS. They can do a lot of things, right? That's what just I wanted to highlight here, my beloved students. So these type of problems also may come. And then if you know the reasons why these bumping sounds are, when there is sometimes when there is a major roof fall which happens, this you should understand. The difference between local fall and roof fall, you must have understood already, we used to discuss. But still, those who are, somebody may unmute and tell me, now it's, what is the major roof fall or the local fall? Anybody want to say now itself? What is the meaning of major fall? What is the meaning of local fall? Let's continue, don't worry. Now, that's the reason why I used to ask you, my beloved students, if you have any doubts, ask me. All the time I used to ask 2-3 times, especially in 1 hour class, after 30 minutes, some 2-3 minutes I want to give for clarification of doubts only. And later, before ending the class, I used to give time for another 1-2 minutes, 5 minutes, whatever, before summarizing many times, right? It's all, you should utilize it. You should have that enthusiasm to know more. Okay. Now, to continue it, bad stability was also estimated. There are so many models I told you, I've shown you also. numerical models, and so many things. And then, of course, any model that we are using for designing the mining methods and talking about our mining methods designed and then implemented, and it should be calibrated. And those might be our students may be interested in the second year student also in future to take up some maybe more interested in some type of electronics or artificial intelligence, machine learning or instrumentation, wireless or cloud computing, it can be whatever, right? Due computing also. Right? So that's my things. And that is the knowledge utilizing these experimental data also. So with all these in view of all these states of pillars when it was nicely monitored, so the based on that, then we will be given a safety factor. We will be able to work where you are able to work safely. Then it also gives you some idea in the next time, in next panels, what type of extra they are supposed to take or what are other requirements as far as your mining method is concerned. And safety of this bed pillar with a 50 meter is estimated to be 1.1. And then head and go far there, that's why is exceeding 1.5 is the barrier which we also recommended or told them it will be more beneficial when they go for 60 meter. So this all gives you some idea that in future how we are supposed to do that. And now before going to deep layering with stowing, this is up to this is about the panel and caving with caving. And here, as I told you, so another CEP for you is your CEP2 is what is local fall versus main fall in our deep layering or in caving, whatever. So this is your CEP2, and now I am going to your main one. Now it is 8:38. Let us have any queries from you or any answers, and meanwhile we'll also take your attendance. Once again, I have taken attendance, and now you can ask if you have any doubts, or you can give your answers, unmuting yourself. Any answers?
Sir, I want answers, to
ask. Answers for CEPs. Yes, you have to tell your name.
Gagan Sahu.
Practice we are doing. Yes. Yes.
Sir, actually, at the time of.
Gagan answering. Yes. Because all these things are being recorded and known to, and many hundreds of people are watching this. And everybody must have had this YouTube links also, so that any time those who are unable to get connected because of any connectivity problems, like our Yogita Madam. Yogita Madam, are you able to hear my voice? Topi laga ke topi nikal. Yes, she is able to hear it. Nice. Yesterday she was having some problem. Achha, Yogita Madam, could you get the YouTube link of yesterday's class? You can unmute and tell me. YouTube link of yesterday's class. Otherwise, get it done and share it here, not only here, for all the classes in your WhatsApp group, in the mail, so that will also help many people. Okay, Gagan, answering. You are giving
answer. At the time of falling of a pillar, the concentrated load over it are distributed among another surrounding pillars, which can cause a damage of the other pillars. That is called overriding.
Very nice. Anything you want to say about the second CEP answer?
Sir, major roof fall is actually the roof which consisting of a major
it's okay, no problem. Anybody want to respond? So yes, as sir. Said that by our Gagan, yes, anybody want to respond?
Sir, myself Shiv Shankar Mishra.
Shiva Shankar.
Yes, sir.
Yes, Shiva Shankar both, but both are different. You know that? Shiva is different and Shankar is different. You know that?
Yes.
Very nice.
Yes, sir.
So yes, now that is Shankar answer.
Right. Yes, sir. I am telling about overriding of fillers. Sir, if our opening strata is constituted of massive sandstone, so there will be a delay in the fall of roof. So simultaneously, when we are extracting the large number of fillers, then roof fall not happening. As after some time, main roof will fall as area of exposure increases. So whenever there is failure of main roof, the pressure will be redistributed on the fillers, which are on the outby side. If our outby side pillars are not strong enough, the pillar will be crushed. So this type of crossing of pillar is known as overriding of pillars.
Very good. So this is for you, both of you people, which we have given to our DGMS yesterday. Right. Very nice. Now to say something more for the benefit of everybody. Now, because depending on your response, I would like to give more and more information, right? Okay. So, you just imagine, right? So, overriding is what our Shankar and Gagan told. They nicely tried to explain. And for all others, and including Gagan and others, right? So, when now you just imagine, this is your panel and that side is the goof. That side is a goof, okay? Right. In that case, what happens? When it is falling inside the goof, this falls like this, very simple. Everybody is able to see, right? This roof, whatever roof layers are there, these layers, it is falling into the goof. And your goof edge should be this place, right? So instead of this, what happens, as said by them, Gagan and Shankar nicely, what happens is, this fall will not take place up to the goof edge, but that goof edge, this edge will enter inside the workings. You try to understand, right? So whatever is falling up to the goof edge, right? It is a conventional, or it is the most safest way of your designing the method and your pillar dimensions, rib dimension, your support system at the goof edge, everything is perfect. But when there is some problem of inadequate supports or whatever, then instead of this cutting taking place at the goof edge, this cutting will crush a part of this adjoining goof edge and enter inside the pillar or inside your workings. That is called overriding of the pillars. So this we should avoid it by proper planning, proper designing the support system, designing your rib dimensions and the goof supports and all. I hope you understood everybody. And yes, I will go further. Yes, Gagan. Gagan and Shankar.
Yes, sir.
You understood nicely. Are you happy with the answer what I could explain to you?
Yes.
Very good. Now you can explain to anybody, right? Very nice. Okay. So regarding other CP, you think over. We will continue the class now. And now we are going to our next part of this. What is that? Yes. But you have taken attendance also. Now you think over other things. CP 2, 3, all these things. Then, now deep layering with story. Now we have seen that why stowing is required. Already you understood. I need not explain again and again. But still, this is the requirement, right? So when we have some important features, such as buildings, it may be rivers, it may be roads, railways, tanks, reservoirs, or it can be anything above the workings. It can be high tension power lines, or even for that matter, we are not supposed to disturb whether there are some type of even even the forest land, when you are disturbing, right, when there is caving and so many cracks developed on the surface of our Mother Earth, right, what happens? Your groundwater level also will go down. And not only that, even your, there will be some other problems, such as when there are groundwater level is going down, otherwise this whatever the roots of the system, any trees, trunks, roots, right? So that also getting disturbed with some cracks and other things. So this type of effects will be there even if it is a forest land. We are not supposed to disturb, and it can be natural some slopes, and below that slopes, which are not mentioned, I am trying to explain to you. Some examples also you may note down, right? While telling this, I will be giving lot of examples where we did personally some investigations in designing some underground coal mining methods, and many of them are also mentioned in our many books, like our Professor R.D. Singh sir's book, right? Or it can be Dr. T.N. Singh's book, Underground Mining Coal. We have given, they have mentioned many experimental trials conducted by us in CMRSR, right? So these two are already there with you. I hope without any problem, you can refer to so many other latest information about the requirements where the stowing is required or backfilling is required. And stowing in general, we used to do it only with your sand for a long time, and nowadays because of some problems of sand availability, now we are looking for some alternative materials. That alternative materials may be many, including overburden, crushed and all, right? And continuing with this, some other circumstances that would require deep layering stowing, now we can see some, in addition to the surface features, what could be the reasons why we should go for this type of stowing. This also will show you some good idea, my beloved students. Here you see, there may be some seams, and then there may be a chance, or there are already some seams extracted, whether it is a above seam or a below seam, whatever, adjoining seams and all, and there may be some fire in the seam, right? And you need not wonder, right? You will be also learning later. We can understand what is the condition even after isolation of the any type of extracted panels. Also, we are monitoring whether there is fire inside or fire extinct, or it is without fire, by sampling and all we have been doing continuously. So that already we have been doing even in GDK 11 inclined mine. Still presently also we have been monitoring, right? And others, since I told you some examples, even in Bartunga Hill, Anjan Hill in Chirimiri, that place. So because of the natural slope, there is some hillside slope, and then there are some stretches below that slope or hill, foot of the hill. So that structure to be protected. So under the hill also when you are working, you should protect that slope. These are different situations. Some examples I told you, you can see lot of references, lot of material. When you write even Bartunga Hill, when you write even Anjan Hill, or Southeastern Coal Field, or GDK 11, or whatever, right? So that's why I used to give these type of examples to you, my beloved students, right? Then C may be under fire. So now you should be in a position to, and you should not create by your mining method in adjoining seams or seams below or above that seam which is already under fire. If you do it by caving, then that may lead to some cracks and other disturbances, which may lead to a connection with that fire area, and you will be under dangerous situations, and there may be some explosions, right? So that's why in that situations also we are supposed to go for some backfilling practice, so that even cracks should not be generated as a part of your method of extraction or exploitation of that particular coal by underground mining methods. That method may be any method, right? But it should be stored back, it should be back, it should be backfilled, so that you should not give any chance to get connected to the places where there is some fire. That's what the meaning of item A, which I kept it in a very beautiful red color. I hope you like sometimes. Now, seem prone to spontaneous eating. You understood what is the meaning of this, right? Then when you are giving scope for your coal, are exposing the coal surface for some time with the oxygen, that chemical reactions, right? So already that coal, this is exothermic reaction, I think 92 kilocalories and all, what is there in the chemistry, anybody can see it. I'm not going into numerical problems there, but you should understand what is the logic behind that. So where in that situations also, it is better to go for stowing or backfilling, so that you should not expose that coal surface. The purpose is different in different situations. Now, then seams which may be liable to bumps, right? There were a lot of stress sir. Conditions. Yes. Yes.
Sir, are you sharing?
Yes.
Sir, are you sharing screen? The slides are not visible.
You should tell me. I'm giving that. Okay, no problem. Now I'm going back again. Is the sharing slide any problem in between? Let me see. Are you able to see the slide now?
Yes, no. Sir.
Very good. Right. So I think you missed any slide. No. This is what we started after your CEP question two. What is the difference between local fall and main fall in deep layering with caving that was there, and in between a gap and stowing, we are discussing this. You have not missed anything with that. Okay, very good. So seams which are prone to spontaneous seeding, you understood it, liable to bump when there is a lot of stress conditions, right? And then it is better to fill it back so that
your voice is not audible.
Sir, you are muted. Sir, unmute yourself, please.
Connectivity problems. I am moving here and there. That also may cause some problems. Okay, don't worry. Are you able to hear now? Hear me now? Yes, no.
Otherwise,
you can make
a call.
Yes. Otherwise, without wasting time, you can make a call to me on this 9938303259, whatever. Or your landline 0661246261. Right. Then, when you want to extract the full scene thickness, it can be 6 meter or 4.8, whatever, right? Then you have to stow it, and then on the stowed face, then you can work other sections going up, right? This is something like a slicing, multi-slicing with stowing in ascending order. In that situations also, we will be going for stowing. That's what is the meaning of this issue, whatever is mentioned here. It can be greater than even 4.8 meter, greater than that also. Depending on the seam thickness. But the logic why it is 8 and greater than 6. Because when it is a 3 meter by development and up to 4.8 also we can extract within a single lift, right? And then if it is more than 6 means what happens, I can have 3 meter in the development and then I fill it another 3 meter and above, I can go by the other lifts, something like that. Okay. Presence of water bearing above the coal seam being extracted, this is one of the important issue that everybody should understand, because here what happens when there is a water bearing strata and then you want to work in adjacent, even adjacent working or under that, then if there is some cracks connected to that, any water bearing strata, then if there is some crack connected to the present working, then water will flow, there will be some inundation problems. That's why it is better to design with some stowing rather than other caving. Then existence of workable seams above or below the seam to be extracted. So here you can see the examples. I can give n number of examples even now where we are doing it. You please note down whether it is a KTK fire mine for which to protect the surface features like high tension power lines or state highways or national highways like that, or even GDK 11 mine where one seam, we are extracting three seam with around 7 meter cutting by blasting gallery with caving, and below the number four seam by stowing. So these are some reasons why we are doing that in many mines for that matter. Number three seam by caving and four seam by stowing with 7 meter parting like that. And in addition to that, there may be some government restrictions which may inhibit us for not going for caving, and then you have to protect so many structures. So this type of situations also may come up before going to a later arrangements. Other things in the next class, we will take up the issues for planning and how it is done, stowing processes, especially in whether it is other mines. At that time, I will show little, but here you will go some more details because for more and you'll go to summary, and things will be going in detail at that time. And later, we start in the next classes in lava mining also. That's why it's where we will go in detail into different mines and long wall mining. That's where we start in the next. We start the, I think on the Friday, we will be discussing all that, even I will be showing you, taking you people into the mines. Like, welcome to Long Wall Pan number 3D, right? You people to different places in the Long Wall panel, how we talk and all those things. We do that, and now these are the directors of mines, other people. Control engineers at that time. I'll be taking you to different mines and different situations of mines, inside the mines of different places. That will be whether it is a stowing. Since we are talking about stowing, here I want to show this. Yes, this is stowing place. Stowing, how it is being done, and this is a stowing pipeline. This is a barricade and how it is done. So now we'll be going back to my students to your CEP answers and summary. So anybody want to give CEP answers now for two and things and then summary? Who will summarize? 1 minute. CEP 0 for all.
Yes, sir, I am answering CP2.
Zero for all except you. What is your name? Except.
Sir, I am answering the CP2.
Except.
Sir, I'll summarize.
Sir, Shiv Shankar Mishra.
Yes, Shankar.
Sir, local pull means, I am saying about the first local pull and then main pull. Local pull, sir, in a deep layering district, the pull which takes place after removal of the supports, that is the local pull. And generally, local pulls occurs within 24 to 48 hours after supporting has been withdrawn. And then comes about main pull. In a deep layering district, when the area of extraction becomes equal to or more than the square of the depth of the working, whatever the effect or cracks or falls takes place, reaches up to the surface. That will observe on the surface in the form of substituents. So this kind of fall is main fall.
Madam, want to say something? Madam, you can say. Want to answer? We have one more time to utilize. Anybody want to say something more? Your summary? anybody to say? So our Shankar nicely explained global fall and minimal fall. The mainly one just to add is I believe our students what happens is whenever we
Sir, you are on mute, sir.
Yeah, connectivity. Are you able to hear my voice? Then what happens? There may be some when you are withdrawing your goods support. These layers, whatever are there, immediate layers up to 1 meter, 2 meter, 3 meter, simply fall. Local fall, okay. May fall means all your growth you expected up to say, exposing 50, 60 meter, that told you 50 to 70 meter of clear sand is your fault. Yes, that is also the rainfall. Your growth is almost filled, and then that may extend even substance of the surface. And at that time, you will see lot of indicators. For example, they are not sweating, and it is something like a thunderstorm. Be hearing that type of sounds of breaking. That is the place. That is a time this major fall, main fall takes place. So you should, whenever in the mind, try to understand the situations whenever you do any visit also. And not the experiences of our minors when you are there. And all the best, my students. All your time is up. All right. Take care of everything. Okay. Dhanyavaad to your parents. And once again, nice answer given by 2 people. So this is the same whenever we ask to our beloved first person, your super, Mr. Pramar. Yesterday, of the day from morning to evening, explaining so many issues of our coal mining. You are all welcome to visit DGMS all the time. Right? That's what you must have observed. Interaction you must have seen. And once again, take care of the team. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat, Bye Caroline. जय हिंद भारत के बाद बोलना है जय हिंद जय ऑल द बेस्ट नाउ रिकॉर्डिंग बट एनी टाइम यू कैन योर क्वेरीज थ्रू आवर व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप एंड ऑल यूट्यूब लिंक्स ऑफ लेक्चर 21 शुड बी अवेलेबल टू एवरीबॉडी एंड देन योगिता मैडम बी मेंटेनिंग इट एंड if there are any problems of connectivity, you all see me from your number one last